Many of you have stumbled upon the video series that's here around animal totems and meditating and connecting with spirit animals and working with animal guides. And so I'd like to share a little bit more about how my journey has evolved since I first created these videos and some tips for connecting deeper with animal medicine in your life. So if you're called to connect with animals in a relational way, let's call it, in receiving the medicine that animals have for us, then first I just want to thank you. Thank you so much for being curious and open to what's available for us when we feel this resonance with animal totems. And so a couple of things that you can play with on your journey is, you know, first just awareness of the animals that live around you and noticing who are the friends in your immediate environment. Right? And like really getting to know them as beings. So one thing that really surprised me when I read a book about birds once was kind of realizing that the birds in my yard are like the same bird, right? So if there's a cardinal that you see around you, it's probably like the cardinal that lives there with you. And it was just a funny realization that really landed in for me that it wasn't just like they weren't just random birds, right? Or like random squirrels or random bunnies, whatever it is. Yes, sometimes animals are migrating through, so that's a thing that can happen, but very often they're your neighbors. And so you get to, really see them and be with them and get to know them. Observe them, get curious about perhaps communicating with them directly, the particular animals that live near you. And so animal communication, this is like another piece here, right? You can like open up your own intuitive capacity, which we all have, to perceive your own, messages from animals, as well as send messages to animals. And so this is something that I've been playing with more and more, and specifically around some of the boundaries that are sometimes needed with animal friends and kind of the way that we have life set up in having gardens and homes. So, for example, there have been mice in kind of the walls of my home. And I had a moment where instead of kind of worrying about it or what to do, I just sat down and meditated and like really opened my heart. And I like know what to do. It's just remembering to do it, of like sending the message and asking the mice to like not live in the walls, right? There's a lot of woods around us. Please live in the woods. And it's been a couple of months and I haven't heard them. And so they like really respected that request to move on. And so there's as we are living with animals, there's sometimes like conversations that need to happen about the practicalities, right? As well as like receiving the medicine. And so there's a way that mouse called that medicine up in me to invite me to remember my power, that I can actually have these conversations and be listened to, right? That I can be seen. And kind of heal that wound of feeling like, oh, it's just all in my head, right? Well, no, it's actually not, because I know the sound of them in the walls, and I know when I haven't heard them in the walls, right? So that it's like the medicine of mouse for me in that example is like, okay, I can trust that this is happening. It's not just in my head, right? So then you can also really tune in and ask to receive messages, right? Sometimes we want to send a message, sometimes we want to receive a message. And so in that process of receiving, know that your intuition can come on in different ways. So some of us are very visual and we maybe see images come in. Some of us maybe feel or have like a sense of felt knowing in our bodies. We may hear like actual word, like as if a voice is speaking to us or kind of like words coming in. And then I've known people who also have the gift of intuition through smell or taste. And so, right? Perhaps other ways that are kind of like beyond the five senses as we think about them. And so cultivating your intuition in connection with animal teachers is a really, really fun and really beautiful opportunity because they can help us see how we see, which is so cool and so exciting. And I'm so grateful for that part of animal medicine. And so play with it. Play with like, how do you perceive? How do you tune in? How do you connect? And what does it feel like for you in your body when you're trusting that process of connection? And so it's beautiful, you know, to like kind of tune in to, you know, books and resources, videos, whatever, to like kind of help activate that. But the real invitation is that it lives here in your heart, that connection with animals. And to know that you can connect with any animal totem at any moment, wherever it is in the world, right? And that some of these spirit animals that show up are really particular to you and might be guides that work with you for a lifetime. And sometimes they come in for like a chapter, you know, like a period of life they show up. And so like trusting that ebb and flow of energies that you may be called to work with and enjoying the process. I hope this is helpful for your journey. Thanks for tuning in.